these candlesticks. Now, tonight there are four handouts for you, as you can see on your screen. Just click on the button to download them. Please download them onto any device you are using in class, and then you can transfer them or move them around later because they are not accessible to you in the recorded version of this class. Okay, but there are no super secret information either. You can get these on the internet. Okay, not these exact printouts, but the same basic information, because candlestick patterns are candlestick patterns. And there are 32 different candlestick patterns that you should know. Now, also in tonight's class, we'll be looking at a couple of presentations I've prepared for you. In the recorded version, you can't see the presentations. So you can get those by going over to YouTube and looking for 4X and CFD education. The link will be in the end of the class for you. But you'll see them in class, but if you want to see them in a recorded version. So also tonight, I'm going to use the term security when referring to any tradable financial instrument. This includes stocks, bonds, commodities, futures, indices, mutual funds, options, cryptocurrency, altcoins, you name it. Now, while I may imply a specific investment product, like I may say shares, I may say Forex, I may say equities, it's only because it gets very boring saying security, security, security. I also intermix the terms investing and trading. While an investor takes a long-term position, a trader takes a much shorter-term position. But in either case, the basic concepts and techniques presented in this class are still equally adept. But I understand most of us are here because we are short-term traders. Now, candlesticks are an ancient trading or charting system. They've been around since the 17th century. But when I started trading about 40 years ago, no, I wasn't trading in the 17th century. Candlesticks, we did hand charting, and candlesticks were time consuming. And then as things moved forward, okay, most of the charts weren't developed to easily put candlesticks on and off and work with candlesticks. But today, all the charting systems, because all the computers have gotten so fast and so easy, and all the charts are HTML and Java, we can put candlesticks on there, we can change the colors, we can do whatever we want to do with them. And we can now get them as fast or use them as quickly as we could a bar chart, which is the most popular Western way of trading. Now, each candlestick represents a data set. If you're using a 30-minute chart, each candlestick represents a 30-minute time frame. If you're using a one-day chart, each candlestick represents a one day, because it's made up of the open, the high, the low, and the close for the period in which you are using in your own individual charting and timing. Okay. So if you decided your strategy, you want to look at a one-hour chart, each candle on that chart will cover that 1 hour. Now, a candlestick is based on four pieces of information. Uh-oh. I just lost my PowerPoint. Give me 1 second. Let's get it back up here. Okay, each candlestick represents four pieces of information: the open, the close, the high, and the low. So what we do as the open price, we put a line across on our chart. At the close price, we put another line across. We put a dot at the highest price that asset traded in that period, and a dot at the lowest price. We connect the dots to the lines, and then we connect the lines to the lines, and this gives us our candlestick. These are known as the wicks. And this is known as the body of the candlestick. If we stepped up from the open to the close, in other words, we climbed up the ladder, we would color it in with green. If we climbed down the ladder from the open to the close, we would color it in with red. Now, I don't want to confuse you, but I need to point something out here. Before we had these amazing new charts we all use, as I said, we were hand charting. So when you would draw the candle on your hand chart, because you were doing it on graph paper yourself, okay, you weren't carrying around red and green candles in your red and green color pencils in your pocket. You were using a regular pencil. So when it was a bullish time frame, or you stepped up from the open to the close, you would just leave it, the body of the candlestick, empty or hollow. When you stepped down from the open to the close, which was a bearish session, you would just use the side of the pencil to color it in. So we used to use the words black and white. And a lot of times when you're reading about candlesticks or learning about candlesticks, or some of the most common patterns are called the three white soldiers, the three black crows, only because they were black and white in those days. We could call them three green soldiers and three red crows, but nobody changes the name of them. Okay. But the fact is, if you decided to use orange and purple, you could use orange and purple as long as you knew which one was bearish and which one was bullish. So again, we have the shadow and the body. And then we have the color of the candle. Now, too many traders, so let's actually just pop up a live chart here. So here we're looking at a 30-minute chart for gold, and we see the candlesticks, and they're in reds and greens. And too many traders get stuck with this psychological thing of red and green and think that an abundance of red is telling you that you should short something, an abundance of green is telling you should buy something. Well, that's got very little to do with candlesticks. Candlesticks are not really about the numbers of reds and greens. They're about the size and the shape of the candle, what that candle is in relationship to the previous candle and the candle after. So when we talk about these candles, different candlesticks, they're based on the body and the wicks. So this candle right here is referred to as a doji. Okay. You see it's got very little body and long equal set of wicks. Okay. Other candles have, here we have a candlestick that also has a name. Okay. And it's because it's got a very long upper wick. We also have candles that we have Marabuzu candles. We have Haramis, because it's really about, though, the size and shape of the body and what is happening in relationship to the previous candle and the current candle and sometimes the candle afterwards. We have what's called engulfing candles, that the next price fully engulfs the previous candle, or haramis, which are like pregnant women, that the new candle is fully engulfed in the body of the previous candle. We have bullish engulfing patterns and bearish engulfing patterns. I've said very little about reds and greens. So let's talk about what these patterns are. And this is why you have the handout. Because there are 32 different candlesticks that you need to understand and know, these positions and patterns. And of these, there are 16 that are very important. Now, I've given to you on a cheat sheet here. But first, before we talk about these different patterns, we looked at the different shapes of the candles, and they tell us there's six basic variations, okay? And they tell us the story about the bulls and the bears and who's in control of the session. So we can see in diagram number one here, We have a normal size candle body with two wicks. What this is telling us, that's a bullish candle because it's hollow or white. And that's telling us that bulls, it was a bullish session. And we can see the bulls basically controlled the markets in that session. Because at some point, the bears were able to pull it to the low, but they weren't able to hold on to it. The bulls pulled it from the open all the way up to the high. And then they weren't able to hold that highest point, but they kept it pretty high. And that's why we got that candle. So the bulls were dominating or were in control in that session. The next candle, number two, is the exact opposite. 3, 4, 5, 6 are relatively the same. Small body candles. Small body candles tell you there's market indecision because the open and the close were relatively the same. Now, we can see in 4 that at some point, the bears were able to yank hard for a second. So imagine it's a tug of war. The bears were able to pull you over the other side of the lake for a second, but they weren't able to hold on to it. It went right back the other way. 5, the bulls were able to yank hard, but weren't able to hold on. Okay. 6, everybody's yanking back and forth, but they still ended up with an open and close that were relatively the same. Now, before turning to single and multiple candlestick patterns, there's a few general guidelines to cover. Now that you have the basic idea what candles indicate with their bodies and wicks, let's cut our teeth on some simple, uncomplicated patterns. Okay. So we have single candlestick patterns, we have double candlesticks and triple candles. Singles are just one candle by themselves. One candle by themselves tells you a little bit about the market, but not enough to help you make any trading decisions. Two candles, this is one candle and then the current candle and the preceding candle. And this covers the bullish engulfing, the bearish engulfing, the bullish tweezers, bearish tweezers. Bullish and bearish engulfing are relatively important because they tell you the markets are about to reverse. Then we get the three candles together that tell you something. And three candles together are very, very important and they tell you a lot. So let me share with you a little presentation about candlesticks and show you what these look like in general. So let me pop this up. So as you can see, there are some standard patterns that are very important. They will show you reversals or they'll show you continuation. So these are all on your cheat sheet. And don't get overwhelmed by all of this stuff. You don't have to memorize the names of the candles. You don't have to memorize the pattern. You just have to be able to see what the candles are trying to tell you. You don't have to remember it's a doji. You don't have to remember it's a harami. You don't have to remember that it's a bullish engulfing. Just when you see this candle fully engulfing the previous one, what is it trying to tell you? But I'm sure when you look at all of those handouts, you look at all these candles, you can get overloaded with this. So now that we've gone through the various patterns and you go to the trading battlefield with your newly acquired knowledge, or you're going to shout, stop it, I'm too confused, these funny names, these shapes, I can't remember any of these. Just remember, each candle and of a candlestick chart is a reflection of the market sentiment. It's not just a standard pattern, but with keen observation, you can master the art of trading by looking at the charts without ever remembering the names of the patterns. So let's go over, and I'm going to show you some shortcuts to actually eliminate all this panic mode you want to be in and allow you to use candlesticks very easily. So let me, because, the patterns have standard rules. And when you have standard rules, we can write computer programs. So investing.com has made it very easy for you. If you go onto the website and just go up under technical and click on candlestick patterns, it's going to give you a place to customize the candlesticks or the assets you like to trade, what type of candles you're looking for, what time frames you're interested in. And then it will then, once you've set it all up, it'll memorize it for you once you set up your login. And it's going to tell you when a pattern develops. So we can see right now that gold in a 1 hour chart is currently in a bullish engulfing, developed a bullish engulfing pattern. And it's telling us to trade, a bearish engulfing pattern, and it's telling us to trade down. If we click on the line and open up, it's going to give us more specifics about all of this. But we can then, once we've customized and set it all up, we can just monitor all the patterns right here on the charts. Okay, with that, then put it on your chart. You don't have to, you can use them to scan it. The other thing is, if you go over to their charts, and click on candlesticks, whatever asset you're looking at, set up the time frame, and it's going to tell you what the most recent patterns are that developed. So we can see we had three black crows 1 hour ago. It's a three-level candle. That's a very important candlestick pattern. And it's got the three candles that developed. We can see exactly what, click on the box to see what the explanation is, but we can also go right on the chart and see it right here. Okay, and see it directly on the chart. So if we go over to the 1 hour chart, okay, it tells me we had three black crows. Here's the three black crows. We can see them all right there. And we can then start trading from there, or we can move it over to whatever chart you're using. It's one easy way to do this, okay, that you don't have to start looking for all the patterns. Okay? Click on the assets you want to watch. Okay? Now, another way is most charting systems today will have scripts. So here we're looking at a chart, a candlestick chart for gold in a 30-minute chart. I'm going to go up here to indicators, and I'm going to click on the indicator button. I'm going to go over here to the library, and I'm going to scroll down and look for candlestick patterns identified. I'm going to click on it and look what it did. Lo and behold, all over my candles, all over my chart, it's given me every candlestick pattern that's developed. Okay. Now, I can customize it by selecting what candlesticks I'm interested in. So I don't trade the doji, I don't trade evening star, I don't trade morning star, I don't trade shooting star. Hammers, I don't care about. These are my personal. I love haramis. I love bullish and bearish engulfing. I don't care about the bullish belt and the bullish kickers. So I'm going to turn all these off. I don't need them all over my charts. And I've left on just the ones I'm interested in. I can then decide how I want them to appear on my charts. I want the words above or below. I want arrows or you know, circles, crosses, diamonds, whatever you want to put on there to make it easier for you to see. You can decide what color you want the text in. Okay. And just click OK. And you, once you set it up, it's then customized for you. But we can see every pattern is developing here right on the charts without wasting our time looking for them and trying to locate them. And regardless of what chart you're using, most charting systems will give you the same type of scripts. And if they don't, you can just use the trading view and then move that pattern or, you know, find, once you've located on here, just look at it on your current charts because it'll be the same pattern that's there because the patterns don't vary by charts. But these are two easy ways that you can find the patterns as they develop on your charts. And that takes a lot of the craziness out of, you know, trying to find the candlesticks, you know, and trying to train your eyes so well. Do that now. There we go. My screen. There we go. Okay, my screen got stuck. So I'm going to share another presentation with you about how you can use a simple interpret price action with the candlesticks. So as you can see, there's many ways that you can adapt candlesticks to your trading. Now, I've sent you via the chat a link. If you want to see these two presentations again, you can see them on YouTube by clicking that link. Please copy that link or click on it now so that you have it. And then you can see the videos right there. But whatever trading timescale you're on, candlesticks can be an incredibly powerful trading tool for helping us to judge what's coming at us from right out of our trading screens. Now, in this webinar, I've only kind of scratched the surface of candlestick charting. There are many, many more patterns that you can learn to recognize. However, the patterns I've chosen to include are the ones that I find most useful. Candlesticks can be very powerful tool, but they are not best used in isolation. Combine them with simple pieces of technical analysis, and they can give you clear signals that the market is ripe for you to open your trade or your close your trade. Use them alone, you may find that you are too close to the price picture to see what's really going on. So let me share with you one more way that you can add candles into your trading and analyze price action. So, as you could see in all of these class, all of these presentations, there are many different ways that you can incorporate candlesticks into your trading and different ways that you can use them to interpret price action. Okay, either by knowing the patterns in the candles, by using some other type of application without sitting so complicated, or by combining them support and resistance. But as you become more and more familiar with candles, you will learn to instinctively read the story that each one is telling you. So hopefully I just gave you a general basics, a primer in the candlestick, something to think about. Don't be scared of candlesticks. In no time at all, you'll be trading from them and making smart decisions. But don't just think because you see red and green, you have to have an understanding of what the candles are trying to tell you. And on that note, I'm going to say goodnight to everybody. Thank you very much for joining us. Thank you for supporting ubcfx.com. And thank you for being part of the investing.com family. Have a good night now.